Hey guys, it's Putty for Rustified here with a quick overview of what's coming into Rust this month. First off, we'll have to address the elephant in the room, or should I say trumpet. With the release of this update comes the Rust Instrument DLC. This content comes with 10 instruments for the price of $10 USD. But before you get up in arms about this DLC content, just know that you don't need the DLC content to play instruments, you just need it to craft new instruments. So, if you don't feel like buying it, you could always steal your desired noisemaker from another player, or you could even test them out at the outpost near the chill zone. You play the new instruments with the numpad keys, 1 through 7 for notes A to G, with the number pad enter bringing the notes up an octave, and the number pad plus making the notes sharp. You could also use a MIDI input if that's more your speed. Just hook up your device and turn on the setting in the menu. Some of you might be wondering about your trusty ear-splitting acoustic guitar. Well, this instrument isn't included in the DLC content, but it has been converted over to the new music system. Also, with all the new noise coming in with this update, they've also implemented a volume slider for instruments. Gary's Mod and Rust are having a collaboration to celebrate 15 years of Gmod. If you own Gary's Mod, you'll be noticing a familiar item popping up in your crafting menu. The Gary's Mod tool gun is similar to the hammer in that you can repair and upgrade items, but however, it's slightly better stats than the hammer, supporting a faster attack rate and a greater range over its wooden counterpart. At last, you no longer have to ask your teammates who's bigger. That's right, you can now look down and see your own body in Rust. This will seem a bit weird at first, but you can now see all the clothing on your body. Oh, and don't worry, all the same censorship options work for your body too. Some smaller things you'll be noticing. Horse movement has seen some improvements. There's been some fixes to batteries losing charge when they are picked up. Tree markers should no longer jump to the other side of the tree. And changes have been made to alt look on boats and horses. This is just a friendly reminder that there are quite a few different things under development for Rust right now, like DHRP, modular cars, and guns and more. There's also going to be a holiday update released later this month, so try not to read too hard at the amount of content in this update, and make sure to read the dev blog for the full scoop on all these different projects going on. This has been a summary of all the significant changes coming into Rust this month. I'm Putty and thanks for watching. If you want to know more about this update or any other update, head on over to rustified.com and don't forget to check us out on the Rustified official servers.